So what part? Is this just a chorus?
It's just a chorus.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Roll camera. Play back.
Thank you, play back. Move the start to you.
When I was on the video shoot, I kind of had a moment where I looked around and there were so many people there working, you know, together to get the video looking as good as it can for me, which is kind of, you know, quite humbling at times.
I've never really been someone's love interest in a video. I think we've had a bit of a falling out. And so he's watching all the old home videos of me and sort of singing about him, being quite sad.
Were they playing the track for the video or anything?
They played it to me, so I had like an emotion to go with.
Right, there was no audio while you were running around?
No, just going with it. They were like, look how you're having the time of your life. I was like, I actually am. I'm working and on the beach, like, what more could you want? And it's sunny.
That's something there, or did it pick up?
It picked up.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think that I'm a flirt, maybe just over-friendly sometimes. Certainly the papers haven't helped in making it out that I might be a ladies' man. I don't think I am at all, to be fair. It's all lies.
Oh, this is a sweetheart.
Yeah, I think we're going to have a lovely day and a bit
Absolutely.
Of a lovely night as well.
Me and a few of my mates went fishing. It's just nice to go back and see everyone. I'm not skint all the time now, and I can give Tom back the 20 quid that I've owed him for about 6 years.
I'll go and place it.
Look
at
that. Oh. So, how is the album going?
It's really good, man.
How was it writing with old G Barlow? G Bar, I think they call him.
G Bar. It's really weird, like, I've genuinely been trying to write that song for, like, years. It's like, it's about not being good enough for the person you're with, and I know all about that. Yeah, I even got all emotional singing it. I was, like, crying in the vocal booth and stuff. All planned.
Come on, son.
Ooh, shh. I mean, that was massive.
That was so big. Why did you...
What do you mean, why did I what?
What, you just
why
went...
Why keep holding the rod? You give me some Fisher-Price line? Oh, I'm well gutted about that.
So when are you going back on the show? You're going to be performing?
Yeah.
So, like...
But it's going to be weird because, well, I didn't think I was going to get judged as badly when there was Simon and everyone there. Now there's, like, Gary and it's his song and it's going to be a bit, like... I forgot the words. At least I'll be able to mouth them to
So it's not going to be easy.
I do worry a lot about stuff. But I haven't been thinking too much about what I'm doing because if I do, I'll probably freak out. Just let it happen. If it happens, it happens, and if it doesn't, I haven't thought about it type thing.
Right.
Doesn't mean I don't care. Not saying I don't care, I care more than I've ever cared about anything.
But he can do it, you know. The great thing about him is he can do it. That boy can sing. And so all he's got to do is go on there and do a great performance.
But I had the opportunity to go and record some of the tracks acoustically at the church studio, which was incredible. Some amazing artists have recorded there. And there's just something really special about the sound in that studio and just a nice vibe.
They're just going to need to do a sound check for the guitar.
Yeah. I've always done songs like this. For money at the weekends, I was always going out and singing acoustically in the pub like this, out on the stool, but usually with a couple of pints of Stella and three people watching that are smashed. Forever make it whole.
when I mess lines up, I do get really frustrated, and it really, really annoys me. It's such a simple thing, you know, you should know the song by that point.
It's the worst thing to try and do if you're a perfectionist.
So, do you want to go for a take? Okay, stand by audio, stand by cameras.
Yeah.
Sound rolling?
Stand by, in 5, 4, 3.
Send a message to my heart. Tell it everything from the start. Send them all the letters, fit them all together, set in stone. Send a message to my heart. Send a message to my heart.
Letters has been around about 6 months nearly. It's one of the first tracks that we wrote down in Brighton. It's really nice to just break it down to how it was when we were writing it, because that's how it sounds when you're writing. It's either that and a piano or a guitar, and it sounds great. I mean, if it works like this, then it's a sign that it's a good song. Voice is quite tired, but that's just how it is. You get in the studio, and when you're writing, you're singing. I didn't really think about, you know, warming up and everything. So I've just been singing for 6 months solid. It's all taking its toll, really. I don't want to go in to start the promotion of the album with a limp. Do you know what I mean? I want to go in there fully fighting fit. There you go. Let's just hope it doesn't go wrong. I'm so excited for everyone to hear the first single.
This is Matt Cardle on Radio 1.
And I'm just in the process of getting my band together.
Yeah, with a couple more, that should be there.
So we can do a warm-up tour and get ready for the X Factor performance.